Hey folks, welcome to Quantsapp and welcome back to yet another video. So are you trading in options and are you trading in directional views of yours? Then this video is for you. Because when we talk about options, not just forming a view, not just forming a forecast is enough. You need to go ahead and choose the right strategy for your forecast as well. In this video, let's understand how can we go ahead and manage our option strategy. Most important of all, in options, we all know that time is going to keep on getting passed and the premium is going to, you know, the time is going to keep on killing our premium. Every passing day we hold an option for, our premium is going to get decayed because of the time component, because of the theta. So how can we go ahead and manage theta when we are trading in options is something what we will learn in this video. To watch the video till the very end. So to start off with, so the first thing that we will learn is about, you know, what are the problems which do exist in a long call. So now talking about a long call, what is a long call or a long put? So this is specifically a naked buy position, how it looks like, be it a long call or be it a long put. The differences will not be there, only the direction aspect of it will change. So now moving ahead, let's create a long call and let's see what are the things which might go against a long call. However, long call is, you know, a strategy which gives you a defined loss and, it gives you an unlimited profit. But there are some restrictions, some limitations even to that strategy. So I am creating a long call. What I'm doing is I'm going ahead and buying 18650 call option. Okay, 233 rupees pick. And I'm just clicking on add button. It is showing me on what various levels of Nifty, how much profit or loss you might make. So the first problem in this strategy is, let's navigate to Greeks. Okay, these are positional Greeks showing you the impact of any Greek. Okay, any Greek on your entire option strategy. Okay, so these are positional Greeks. So basically nothing, just the value, the absolute value is shown to us over here. How much in terms of absolute rupees this component is going to affect our option strategy is shown over here. Now theta is minus 255 in this strategy. That means every passing day you hold this option strategy for, 254 rupees are going to get decayed. So if you buy this option strategy, if you are creating this option strategy, 255 rupees is something what you are going to lose for sure. If market remains exactly over there, even if nothing happens in the market. So this is called as theta negative strategy. Okay. So the first thing is theta. Okay. And it is negative. Okay. So this is a theta negative strategy. So this is our first problem. Second problem is that if you just focus on break even. Okay. Now just focus on break even. So this is showing us T plus zero break even as of now. If you move the day slider, so basically it will show your T plus N break even, and this is expiry break even. Now, if you move the day slider, you will see the changes. Now, let's say if my forecast takes 17 days from here, then from the current level, market has to at least move 200 points positive. Where would be my break even? My break even would be 18,845. From that point, I'm not saying you will make, you know, a very significant profit, but at least that is your no profit, no loss. So if you are having a forecast and which, you know, which might take some time, it will shift your break even away from you. So market needs to travel more if there is a lot of time involved. Main culprit, however, is the time. But still, the second thing is the break even. Okay, it gets shifted away from your forecast. Now, third thing is, now the problem with this strategy is, now let's say if your view goes horribly wrong. Now let's say the moment you bought an option, from that very day itself market reversed and it is giving you a loss. So the maximum loss in this strategy, just focus on this. Okay, just focus on this. It is how much? 11,653. That means your loss is limited, but you can end up losing the entire premium that you have paid. Okay, you might end up making a loss of the entire premium that you have paid. So that is our, you know, one of the crucial aspect of the strategy, or crucial limitation, or very important limitation of the strategy. Max loss is equal to premium paid. That means entire premium can get lost. So now the question is, can we go ahead and do some adjustment in our the strategy? Not by going ahead and selling a put option. Okay, that is not what it is. Because the thing is, in put option, if I just show you in put option, your losses would be undefined. Okay, you will face a scenario of an undefined loss, which you don't want to take. Okay, so if you sell a put option, this thing will not be valid. Okay, you will not be able to defend this maximum loss thing any which ways, right? A short put will give you an undefined loss. So that is the reason we want a limited loss strategy only, but we want to make sure that, you know, it also offsets all of these three things. So can we go ahead and do it? Yes, it is very simple thing. And I would say if you are getting started and in options trading, these are few strategies which you should, you know, start practicing, because these are very simple to execute and very simple to monitor, and you will have nowhere an undefined loss. So what I'm doing is I'm going ahead and selecting off the same expiry. I'm going ahead and selling 19,100 strike price call option. This is what my bull call spread is. So this is called as bull call spread. What I did, I went ahead and sold one more call option, okay, of 19,100 strike price. So what you need to do is basically you need to buy a option, okay? You need to go ahead and buy a call option, and you need to go ahead and sell a out of the money call option. That is what creates a bull call spread. Now just navigate to Theta or Greeks, then see where you were losing, what, 255 rupees? How much you are losing? Just 86 rupees. That gives you an edge. So in bull call spread, the Theta is negative, okay? So let's say in bull call spread, the Theta, it is negative, but it is manageable. You are not losing a big chunk to Theta. You are losing in this strategy as well to Theta, but you are losing a very small quantum to Theta. Now coming to the other aspect of this, now just check the break even. It was 18,850, right, in the long call. How much it is now? 18,780. So even your break even is getting shifted. Third thing is maximum loss in the first strategy. What was your maximum loss? Your maximum loss was the premium that you have paid, which was roughly around 11,000. In this strategy, it is 8,680 rupees, which tells you that if your forecast takes time. Now the question remains, when we can deploy the bull call spread? So the answer is very simple. Whenever you feel, okay, whenever you feel that market will take time to move in your direction, only then you will create a bull call spread. You will not go ahead and create a bull call spread every now and then. Only when you feel that, you know, market will take some time to move in your desired direction, only then you can take a, you know, try to practice a bull call spread. So that is the case with bull call spread. Now, another thing what you can do is you can create another strategy out of this. Okay. But before that, let me tell you the operational aspects of this strategy. So your maximum loss, okay, your maximum loss will start from the leg that you have bought. 18,650, okay. So your maximum loss in this strategy is equal to bought leg, okay, bought call, and your maximum profit starts from the sold strike. Max profit start is equal to sold call. So now the trick over here is wherever you feel that market will go, you will go ahead and sell the call option. Whatever your target is, just sell a call option of that strike price. Okay. And you can consider buying an at the money call option. Now talking about this thing, which is the maximum loss in terms of rupees, it would be the net debit of this strategy. Okay. So in this strategy, 233 rupees you paid to enter, this particular thing, okay, this particular call option, to buy a call option. And then you sold an option as well, right, at 59.45. So the difference between the bought and the sold leg would be your maximum loss in strategy, okay. Max loss is equal to net debit. So this is, you know, a bull call spread. Now, can we go ahead and do some optimization in the strategy? So now talking about different other strategies, if you do this thing for a bearish view, you will simply go ahead with a bear put spread. That means you will go ahead and buy a put option and you will sell out of the money put option. We can do same strategies for bearish forecast of ours. Let's say I am feeling market is bearish and it might take time. So what we will do is we will simply go ahead and, you know, buy a put option. Okay, we will go ahead and buy a put option of at the money maybe, or you can choose strikes, you know, from looking at the liquidity as well. And you will go ahead and sell the put option out of the money. Okay, go ahead and sell a put option out of the money. So this will create a bear put spread. So it is a bearish strategy and it is showing us, you know, on what level of Nifty, how much profit or loss you might make. So if you are bearish on the Nifty, and if you feel that market will take some time to move in your direction, then you can do this. So now another thing what we can tackle around is Theta. It was negative. It was manageable, but it was negative. Can we go ahead and manage that? The answer is yes. But this time we need to go ahead and use credit strategies. That means wherein the inflow is happening, the premium is coming to us, we are receiving the premium. Okay. So now we can create such credit strategies by using call option or for the bearish view and using put option for the bullish view. So what I'll do is I'll go to custom strategy and I'll show you for call, you know, for a bullish view. So now I'm selecting the expiry as 29th of December and I'm selecting a put option. Now what I'm doing is I'm going a bit in the money. I'm going a bit in the money and I'm selling a put option, which is a bullish forecast. And now I am going and buying a out of the money put option so that I am not open on my legs. I am not facing an undefined loss. So let's say 18,500 or maybe 18,400 put option. Okay. This is what makes it a bull put spread. What the strategy is called? The strategy is called as bull put spread, wherein it will show us on, you know, you can navigate in Architect and see on what various levels of, you know, Nifty, how much profit or loss this strategy gives us. So now if you just see this strategy, you completely offsetted the Theta, right? You're neither winning from the Theta, neither you're losing any money to Theta. So this is the best part about the credit spreads, the credit vertical spreads. So there are two types of credit vertical spreads, bull put spread and a bear call spread. That means you will make a bearish strategy, but using the call options.